If the Pinckney draft was used as copy for the printer, it is plain enough that the clause of six words, by the states which they represent, may have misled the committee. With the many propositions which they had to codify, and the brief time within which the work must be done, and the confused and somewhat contradictory action of the Committee of the Whole, and the Convention in June, and the divided responsibility and scrutiny of five men, it is easily possible that the committee were misled by the provision in the Pinckney draft. But it is not possible that they could have been so misled if there had been no Pinckney draft, and they had followed the third and fourth resolutions, and borne in mind the action of the convention and the words of its leading members. A second deviation from the instructions given by the convention relates to the payment of the executive. The 12th resolution says that the executive is to receive a fixed compensation for the devotion of his time to the public service to be paid out of the public treasury. The Pinckney draft, Article 8, says that the president shall receive a compensation which shall not be increased or diminished during his continuation in office, and stops there. The draft of the committee, Article 10, Section 2, says, he shall, at stated times, receive for his services a compensation which shall neither be increased nor diminished during his continuance in office, and stops there.